Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to see all of you today. I want to wish a happy belated 4th of July to everyone. Some of us were out of town this week, but it's good to be back together. I had some folks when we were at Salkehatchee who said, "How are you getting your sermon for Sunday done this week?" I said, "I'm not." I'm grateful that our choir is leading us in a very special service today as we get to celebrate God's grace in our lives, and we also get to celebrate where we are and where we live together. I invite you as we continue this time of worship to join me in prayer. Loving God, we thank you for this new day. We thank you for your love and grace in our lives. We especially on this day thank you for the privilege and the ability we have to worship you freely, to gather like this and to sing your praises without fear of punishment, fear of being ridiculed, that we have the ability to do this, and so we give you thanks for that. God, as we sing your praises, as we gather and join our voices as one, we ask that you be glorified through all that we do, and that you would pour out your love and grace in our lives in a powerful way. We thank you and pray all these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Mount Zion United Methodist Church. We're happy to have you here worshiping with us today. I'll just draw your attention to a few announcements in the bulletin. First, you'll see a couple inserts, but this insert for our small groups, as we've been discussing the last couple weeks, post-general conference small groups. So please make sure you put this in the bulletin with the time, if you prefer in-person or virtual, and what days are good for you. There's no Bible study and dinner at the Parsonage this Wednesday. Those will resume on July 24th. Coffee and conversations, that's still happening this Thursday, July 11th. The United Methodist Women will meet July 10th at 10 a.m. And then the Beverly Smith Guild will meet July 10th at 6 p.m. at Palmetto Pizza. And let's see, Loads of Love, you'll see the next Loads of Love date, July 27th from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., and you'll see some more information about that. We've paid for more than $1,000 in laundry so far. And then Central Academy of the Arts school supplies, you'll see listed. We're collecting in all of July, we're collecting here those school supplies. So make sure you see the list of things, and please bring those on Sundays with you. Any other announcements?
I'll share one for you. Okay. So John Reeves wanted me to pass this along, and I'm assuming he cleared this with Christine first. But on Sunday, July 21st, all the children and youth and their families are invited to come over to the Reeves pool at 3:30. Dinner will be around 5:30 or 6. Burgers, hot dogs, and drinks will be provided, and families can bring chips and sides and that kind of stuff. So again, assuming that Christine has cleared this, that Sunday, July 21st at 3:30. All right.
Thank you, John and Christine. And it's good to have, I mentioned it's good to have Robin here playing with us this morning. And then her husband Brian and I, when we were kids, we went to the Reeves to play in the pool, didn't we? Any other announcements? All right, please join me for the call to worship found in your bulletin. I'll read the regular print and you respond in bold. And we have a lot of responsive readings today, so be prepared. The realm of God has come near. Enter this time of worship with joyous expectation.
We lift up to you, O God, for you have drawn us up. You rescued us.
Sing praises to God, all faithful ones. Give thanks to God's holy name.
We have known your favor, O God, in many places. You have healed us and turned our mourning to dancing.
Rejoice in the work you are given to do. Give thanks that your names are known to God.
We will praise you, O God, and not be silent. We will give thanks to you forever.
Please stand as you're able as we sing our opening hymn that is printed in the bulletin. Please be seated. I invite you to join me in a litany for Independence Day that's printed in your bulletin. As we remember the birth of our nation and the gifts of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, let us offer our thanks and prayers to God, the giver of all good gifts, for the women and men who brave the long journey by sea to come to this new world. We thank you, Lord, for the tribes and nations who inhabited this land for generation upon generation. We thank you, Lord, for patriots who dreamed of and fought for a free nation. We thank you, Lord, for the men and women who laid the foundation of our democracy and who pledged liberty and justice for all. We thank you, Lord. For those who built this country brick by brick, road by road, and town by town, we thank you, Lord. For the brave soldiers who have fought for our country, for all who paid for our freedom by their service, and those who paid by their sacrifice, we thank you, Lord. For the innovators and artists, poets and teachers, farmers and factory workers, for all who labor and provide for the common good, we thank you, Lord. For this land, with its peaks and valleys, coasts and deserts, fields and meadows, we thank you, Lord. For our own community, for those who came before us in this place and for our neighbors near and far.
We thank you, Lord.
Lord, we pray for the United States, that we might always be a nation which defends and promotes liberty, freedom, truth, and justice.
We pray to you, Lord,
that we might always be a nation where all are free to worship and pray.
We pray to you, Lord,
that we might be a beacon of freedom to all those who live under the shadow of terror and hopelessness.
We pray to you, Lord,
that those who are elected to govern and lead would be guided by you and be ever aware of the trust that has been given to them.
We pray to you, Lord,
that we would be a people who repent from our sins and who always return to you and to your grace.
We pray to you, Lord.
Gracious God, Father of all nations, bless and defend us and our land. Prosper the work of our hands, and increase in us your grace and compassion, and our offerings of thanks to you, our rock and our salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able as we sing our hymn number 697.
Our responsive reading can be found in your bulletin. I'll read in regular print, and you respond in bold. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His love endures forever.
Give thanks to the God of gods.
We believe in one God, the Father, and the Almighty.
Give thanks to the Lord of lords.
Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen.
To him who alone does great wonders.
His love endures forever.
Who by his understanding made the heavens.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God.
Who spread out the earth upon the waters.
Eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light.
Who made the great lights.
True God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father.
The Son to govern the day.
Through him all things.
The moon and stars to govern the night.
For us and for our salvation, you came down from heaven.
To him who struck down the firstborn of Egypt.
Was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became fully human.
And brought Israel out from among them.
For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
With a mighty hand and outstretched arm.
He suffered death.
To him who divided the Red Sea asunder.
On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures.
And brought Israel through the midst of it.
He ascended to heaven.
But swept Pharaoh and his army into the Red Sea.
And is seated at the right hand of the Father.
To him who led his people through the desert.
His love endures forever.
Who struck down great kings. And killed mighty kings.
And his kingdom will have no end.
Sion, king of the Amorites.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, and the giver of life.
And Og, king of Bashan.
Who proceeds from the Father and his Son.
And gave their land as an inheritance.
With the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified.
An inheritance to his servant Israel.
Who was spoken through the prophets.
To the one who remembered us in our low estate.
We believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church.
And freed us from our enemies.
We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
And who gives food to every creature.
We look for the resurrection of the dead.
Give thanks to the God of heaven.
Having recited God's goodness and faithfulness to his people over the years, we have the opportunity to respond to that love and grace by giving back to God God's tithes and our offerings.
Thank you.
us pray. O loving God, you have provided so much for us. Not just the material things that we have, but also the resources all around us that sustain us and allow us to do your work. God, we ask that as we entrust some of what we possess back to you, open our hearts and our minds to the truth that there is nothing that we possess, only things that belong to you that we get to steward, and bless all that we have given back so that others might know your love and your grace more fully. We thank you and pray these things in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. As we turn to a time of prayer, I know that we want to lift up, as we always do, Kane's friend Debbie in our prayers. We want to remember to lift her up and her situation. I also just want to share a praise. When I got back from Salkehatchee, I had a bunch of mail sitting in my mailbox. Some of it might have been bills, which I'll pass along to any of you who'd like to pay them. But one of them was this letter from the Global Ministries of the United Methodist Church thanking us for a $425 contribution to UMCOR. That's the disaster relief arm of the United Methodist Church. I had shared a few weeks back that I think Jerry and David had been doing some work going through the church's accounts and making sure that all the money that had been given for particular purposes had actually been sent to where it was supposed to go. And so they had run across that money that had been given to UMCOR that had not been sent yet. And so I just praise God and celebrate the good work that's able to be done through Mount Zion, sharing this gift and the many other churches who sustain that ministry, that important ministry. I also just want to lift up a praise for Salkehatchee. I know there were a number of you who reached out to me over the week just saying y'all are in our prayers, and we appreciate it, especially the prayers for lower temperatures on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. That was great. But I just want to praise God, especially for the other folks who went to Salkehatchee. I know I got to work with Braylon, and we did all kinds of different work at our site, but there were so many times where she didn't even ask, what do I need to do? She would just find something that needed to be done and would do it. I didn't get to work with Quint, but I know he was on a roof all week, and I don't know if I'm more impressed that he did that or the fact that I don't see any sunburn on you, Quint. Which means you were wearing your sunscreen, which is good because some of the others weren't doing that. But there's just a lot for this church to be proud of. Not every teenager would devote a week to going in the hot temperatures. And Grace and I also want to praise God for you going the week before to Bishopville. I understand you had a heat index of 108
on Wednesday.
Yeah, that's why we went to Lake City. It's cooler there. And I know she's not here today, but Janet Evett, who went with us as well, many of you know that anytime you do anything in church with children or youth, you have to have at least two unrelated adults. And so if it had just been me, we couldn't have gone. And so the fact that Janet took a week of vacation time from work to go exhaust herself, you know, at Salkehatchee, I just praise God for that. And I hope you will share your words of affirmation to her when she's back and rested. Yeah.
The church did me all.
Absolutely.
And the men produced lunch that day. So thank you to everybody that helped serve with that.
Yes.
And it was small, 36 people. I mean, that's how many people at your house, different from years past, we served 180. So.
Yeah.
But it was still wonderful. They were so appreciative.
Yeah. And so Elizabeth beat me to my last point, and that is the praise for those who provided meals for the Pendleton Salkehatchee camp. When you're out working all day, refueling is essential. And so the groups that come and do that, that is so necessary. So thank you, Elizabeth, for coordinating so much of that and for all those who helped make that happen. Are there other prayers or praises today to share with one another. Whichever Gelder, raise your hand first.
My dad had his knee surgery, the first of two, on Tuesday, and it went extremely well.
Good.
He was in there for 2.5 hours, that kind of thing, and came out and is getting around okay, and is not in extreme pain. Mm-hmm. He's uncomfortable, but he's doing very well. So.
Good. Good, good. Wonderful. So if you couldn't hear Drew, his dad had his first knee surgery this past week, and that went well. And then for Drew's nephew, who fell and broke his arm for the second time in the same place, but had surgery and seems to be doing well. So we will pray for you, Lucy, as you go off to Girl Scout camp for a week. I think you will do great. It sounds like a lot of fun. Are there other prayers or praises today? Yeah, Benji.
I was going to mention some of the things you mentioned about Saugatchie, but thanks for all the men that helped serve lunch on Monday, and then thanks to everyone who helped sponsor our participants that went. And then you mentioned Grayson, Quinn, Raylan, and Janet, but I just want to send a special praise to you for going, Jonathan, and taking your time to do that and set such a good example. And I understand he still has a basketball game too, so he still has game on the court.
I played basketball Saturday night, and then I didn't touch the basketball court the rest of the week. I have game, not games. Yeah, Bonnie. Yeah. So prayers for Bonnie as she travels to Florida and back. Are there others? Yes, Steve.
I'd just like to thank Ed Martin and crew for fixing your water line at the park. We had it all rectified, but they decided to break out in the yard. So we got that fixed for you. We were planning on going through the whole thing without it, but that didn't have to happen.
Yeah. There's something about me going to Saugatchie where some kind of catastrophe happens at home. So for when the water started leaking on whatever, Saturday or Sunday?
About 2 hours after
I left. I went to Lake City where there is no water, and then there was almost Lake City in our basement. So a huge thanks to Ed and Scott and Steve and everybody who help that situation. Did I see?
We left very important people. Ed and Katie Martin served dinner.
Yeah.
Thursday on the
4th of July. Thank you all. Yeah, and Karen Martin served dinner on the 4th of July. Nobody likes to sign up for that night for some reason. And so they do that every year. And that's amazing that three of the meals for that Saugatchie camp came from this church. That's amazing. Are there any others, prayers or praises?
Praise.
Yeah.
I'm not
going to
say today.
Hallelujah. Parn was telling Sherry earlier, he said, I'm retiring from singing. And she said, well, I'm sorry to hear that. I said, are you sorry to hear the singing or sorry to hear that he retired from singing? Anytime you want to sing, it's okay. If there are no others, let's join our hearts in a time of prayer. Loving God, we thank you for laughter. We thank you for celebrations and for praises. We thank you for those who have endured physical challenges, who are finding healing and health. We thank you and especially lift up Drew's dad and Drew's nephew as they recover from surgeries. God, we lift up those who are traveling. There are a lot of people on the road this time of year. We especially lift up to you, Bonnie, as she travels to Florida and back. Give her safety and security as she goes and returns home. God, we lift up Debbie and all those who are in difficult situations, and just that you would watch over her and allow each of us to know the love and support of having loved ones around us, to care for us and to listen to us and to provide for our needs when it's difficult for us to do that on our own. God, I lift up and just celebrate so many disciples from this congregation who have served you and continue to serve you in such meaningful ways. Especially these past few weeks, I give you thanks for those who have gone and volunteered at Salkehatchie, who've endured heat and long days of hard work that have given hope to people who may not have had hope before. God, I ask that that spark that has been lit in the lives of those who were served, as well as in the lives of those who served, that it would continue to grow and give light to those around them. God, we give you thanks for all those who served meals at Salkehatchie here locally this past week. And just thank you for providing not just the resources, but the people to do that. I thank you for the time and the energy that was invested in that camp this week, and that you would bless all those who prepared those meals this past week. God, I give you thanks and praise for this church's generosity in supporting UMCOR. And thank you for the families and the lives that will be touched in times of desperation by that generosity as they find healing and restoration and wholeness. God, we also, especially today, lift up Lucy as she goes off to camp. A week can feel like a long time. It can also go by so quickly. And we just ask that as she goes through that time away from her family, that she will feel her family's love with her, that she will feel your presence with her, and that she will get to experience the joy that comes with making new friends and building relationships, maybe with old friends, and growing as she has fun with others. God, we thank you again for your love and grace in our lives, and ask that you would watch over all those situations we've named and those that we hold in the silence of our hearts as we entrust them to your love and care. We thank you and pray these things in the name of your Son, Jesus, the one who taught us to pray together, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen." Well, Benji's coming forward to lead us in the responsive gospel reading. We get to hear, we talk a lot this time of year about freedom and what that means. And in the gospels, it talks about freedom in a little bit of a different way. And so we get to hear some of Jesus's words about what it means for us to be free and how we find freedom through him.
So please stand. Our gospel reading is John 8, verses 31 through 36. Then Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples.
And you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free."
They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying you will be made free?"
Jesus answered,
"The slave does not have a permanent place in the household.
The son has a place there forever.
So if the son makes you free,
you will be free indeed."
Please remain standing for our
Please be seated. And I invite you to join me together in the prayer that's printed in your bulletin. Almighty God, you rule all the peoples of the earth. Inspire the minds of all women and men to whom you have committed the responsibility of government and leadership in the nations of the world. Give to them the vision of truth and justice, that by their counsel all nations and peoples may work together. Give to the people of our country zeal for justice and strength of forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will. Forgive our shortcomings as a nation. Purify our hearts to see and love the truth. We pray all these things through Jesus Christ. Amen.
You take our
Thank you.